For thousands of years, the Andean condor, the biggest flying bird on Earth, lived in harmony with the native communities of South America, who considered it the spirit of the Andes, a sacred bond between men and God. However, after the invasion of America, the conquerors declared it a plague and brutally slaughtered it in the wrong belief that it killed and harassed their cattle, when in fact, the Andean condor is a scavenger that feeds only on animal carcasses and do not kill live prey. Though abandoned in other times, today its survival is at risk and has become a conservation challenge for all of us. Its unjustified killing has drawn it to extinction in big patches all around its distribution area. Finally, in 1991, this wrong belief that still remains deeply rooted among the population, as well as the environmental threats that have recently appeared, brought about the necessity for the creation of the Andean Condor Conservation Project in Argentina. Condors have a low reproductive rate. In fact, during their best egg-laying seasons, they only lay one egg and raise one fledgling every 2 or 3 years. Nevertheless, when we are working with these birds in captivity, it is possible to withdraw one egg and stimulate a second laying in about a month time that remains under the custody of the couple. Those eggs that are collected in the different zoos are transferred to the artificial incubation center, where they are measured, weighed, and cautiously placed in the incubator. Every week, the embryo's development within the egg is monitored by transparency. Temperature and humidity parameters are carefully controlled during the months that incubation lasts. 3 days will pass by from the time of pipping to the hatching of the egg, and during all this period, the chick is assisted so as to minimize birth risks. The chicks, raised in human isolation, are cautiously looked after by latex puppets that represent their parents. In this way, the recognition of their own species is favored. Later on, they are transferred to maturation enclosures where they complete their feathering process until they are ready to be included in releasing programs. For more than a decade, the project has received many warnings from different regions of our country, informing us about specimens that have been victims of unscrupulous hunters, hurt by snares or captured by illegal dealers. In order to face this demand, the Andean Condor Rescue Center was created as a conservation tool for the rehabilitation of these fantastic birds. Once they have arrived at the center, sanitary studies are performed on them, as well as surgery is necessary. Once they are fully recovered, their general health condition is examined in order to assign them either to ex situ conservation programs or to releasing programs. The raised chicks, together with the rescued ones, are all released in their natural habitats. The project has already performed releases all through the Andean mountain range, the Andes, in all its extent. In December 1997, five chicks were released in Valle Encantado, Patagonia, Argentina. These were the first ones in the entire world to carry solar satellite transmitters on their wings. Subsequently, two more releases took place in Venezuela, where the species was declared extinct in 1965. The release of the Andean condors in Bolivia was also assisted. Moreover, within the framework of the binational Andean Condor Conservation Program created by Argentina and Chile, four more releases were accomplished in both countries. Andean condor is capable of flying unimaginable, extraordinary distances. Its trace and study have been a challenge that we are starting to confront thanks to the incorporation of satellite technology. This modern tool, together with intensive field work, have allowed us to study them deeply in their titanic daily journeys through such a harsh environment as the Andean mountain range. Day after day, we learn not only new features of their biology, behavior, and places they choose to sleep or nest, but also of the use they make of their environment. Thanks to all this information, we are capable of taking conservation measures to ensure the survival of these magnificent birds and the balance of their majestic environment as well. Both the satellite data and the field survey information are loaded into a geographic information system, specific for these species, that allows the interpretation of their flights. Furthermore, we were able to design a new specialized software, the DECOSAT. Simulating the condor's flights, these programs help us comprehend satisfactorily their flying patterns. The race and rescue programs are a powerful weapon, yet the education of the community is crucial in order to achieve a cultural change within society. Thanks to educational programs that are carried out in rural schools and big cities, the clear message of conservation is passed on to thousands of kids. The project has two interpretation centers, the Condor Cabin and Patagonia Alive, where millions of people are received every year. If we want to guarantee the continuity of life on Earth, we must change our relationship with the surrounding environment. As regards this, it is worth highlighting the relationship established with the native communities of the Andes. Before each release, they are the ones in charge of sending their prayers as a message of hope, following the millenary traditions of their cultures.
Libertad diciendo.
Turn one condor to its own habitat. Yet we know that it only takes seconds to put an end to its life. Of us, as feathers of one same condor, will continue working together so as to ensure that the spirit of the Andes recovers its own, one and only place.